us, Admiral Gray's alive, and Krotek left the city with his tail between his legs. The Higgs are on the back foot. Gray wants to take the fight to them. The ISA took down a cruiser in the bay. The Higgs are trying to repair it, sucking half the city's power from the grid in the process. Once it's operational, they'll use it to ship stolen ISA weapons technology back to Helgen. And here's the icing on the cake. That cruiser carries the codes used to encrypt transmissions between the Helgast fleet. Securing those codes could give the ISA the edge they need. Your job is to hack the comm servers for the codes, then scuttle the cruiser.
I'll set charges on the munitions magazines while you hack the codes. Then we'll hit the engine room.
This'll be a covert op. Just you and Ivanov. And the cruiser is heavily guarded. Once they know you're there, they'll throw everything at you.
Our best option looks like an approach by boat, then work our way through the bombed-out buildings onto the cruiser.
I'm afraid you'll have to improvise an evac. The stakes are high on this one, but so's the paycheck.
I'll take those odds. This is one mission I'd do for free, if it helps kick the Higg bastards off my planet.
Alrighty. Woo, I can finally talk. I can move my leg. Oh, that was great. Woo, my leg was itching so bad. Okay, we're right at the checkpoint. Alright, sweet. Hold on, let me just get situated. I'm gonna back this up a little bit more than part one, I should say. Let me turn that up. Oh, this gun is gonna be super loud. I forgot I was using the DLC gun. But first of all, if you guys want to see a review of this game, make sure to check this game out on my PlayStation reviews playlist. Oh damn it, I shouldn't have done that. I forgot. I normally go stealthy right here. It's fun going stealthy, but I guess not. Alright, I do not remember where I'm going. Up here, okay. I know there's a sniper up here I can sneak up on.
Okay, I can work with that too.
Oh, I love that burp. I just had to get that out. But, what are you guys doing right now? Obviously, you guys are watching my video, but what were you doing? Were you thinking, man, I can't wait to go watch the greatest YouTuber of all time? Debatably, you know, you can debate that. Actually, like, not even thinking that I'm amazing. But for people that still support Vita and do Vita videos, I think I am the greatest. You know why? Because there isn't anyone else. Boom. That's how you be the greatest. Actually, listen here, life tips with Austin. If you want to be the greatest at something, pick something that no one else wants to do. And do it. You don't even have to do it well. Fucking die, you little shit. You don't even have to do it well, you just gotta do it. Because no one else does, so it's like, boom. Did you do that? No, I'm the greatest. I set the record. Like, you can set the record for most hours slept in a day. Like, is that even a record? No. Looks like you're gonna make it one. Most videos watched on my channel in a day. Actually, we can hold that record, okay? We're gonna have to have video evidence, and we're gonna start that competition, alright? Who can watch more videos of mine in one day? Shit, they all know I'm here. Okay, that was kinda stupid. Anyway, that dude I just killed, he's captain. You can see it on the mini-map. There's a little line under his arrow. Yeah, okay, see? And you can interrogate those guys and get info on the storyline. Oh, man, I actually think that's the dude I was missing. Wow. Because I always kill him, because I always think I already got him. Because I always get him, like, right away, but I guess not. We're going to have to fuck you up. Listen here. Damn. Oh, right in the ear. Man, that... Oh. Shit, that would hurt. But we're just gonna run past those guys, because we don't need them in our life. We don't need all that. Fuck off. I'm so gonna die. Fucking Bushman can fucking see through walls. But we don't need all their negativity, so we're just gonna run right past them. After I spawn in. Obviously. Run. What? No, honestly. No, I'm not dealing with this, okay? I just came back from football. I'm not dealing with this, okay? Listen here. We're not even gonna be quiet about it. We're just gonna... Oh, so these are the guys. Oh, see? See, if I didn't go loud, I wouldn't have gotten the hipfire gold. Oh, there's frame drops. Here, we're just gonna get you. Go. Sometimes the touchscreen doesn't work as well. But I'm not swiping as good. Oh, normally I have a silence gun for this, but who the fuck cares? Oh. More frame rate drops. Jeez. Shit. Please don't see me. Shit, they saw me. I'm trying to get that captain without going silent, because you go stealthy. That's just boring.
this.
Alright, come on. No, I can't. Okay. But yeah, we got Ivanov. He's giving some backstory on Diordum, where we are. It's the city in Vecta, which is the ISA's planet. So yeah. The subtitles seem a lot quieter. Here, let me actually check it. Fuck off, I already heard that quote. Okay, this is loud. I don't know how loud it is for you guys. I was told in the comments on a Resistance video when I turned it down, because I felt like it was too loud. Apparently it was good volume, and I actually made it worse by turning it down. So, if you're watching this, I'm actually sorry. If I could go back and make the, I can make the video louder, but if I could make only the dialogue louder, I would definitely have done that for you, buddy. But, yeah, this is the Hellgas Cruiser, if we can see. Yeah, there's the building we were on last mission. And we were on the side of it, and this is it crashed. So, yeah. Boom. Actually, I think we were up there. I don't remember. Okay, zipline. I thought I could drop right down, but I couldn't. Fun fact, okay? I'm going to tell you guys some information nobody needs to know or wants to know. Ziplines in this game are in multiplayer. Wait, are they? Actually, oh yeah, they are, okay. I had to think about it. I was like, what match are they in? I really think it's only in one. I think it's in Skyline. That's about it. But, oh, I didn't even know you could parkour on this shit all the way past everybody. That's awesome. Whoa, that would have made this covert playthrough so much easier. Stealth bonus, my ass cheeks. Oh my god, I think this captain's the dude I'm missing. This dude is so difficult to kill. There's a guy here. No, fucking die. Listen, these bitches, they got like ballistic on us. Oh my god. I'm just gonna start hip firing. I'm just gonna run up on him and hip fire. But, I don't even know what to talk about this video. I don't even have any planned out commentary. I don't script my videos, but I normally go into it with a thought, like, man, what am I gonna talk about? The usual, how's your day? Shit, you ballistic bitch. Listen here, you fucker. You're dead. Okay. Hold on, time out, I gotta reload. Yo, time out! Oh shit, that wasn't a good idea. Oh, how'd I heal? Run, okay. We're gonna make a cut here, guys. I'm just gonna cut in after I kill these guys, because I already died once this video, that's the rule. Alrighty guys, we're back. We killed him. We didn't get the captain. I was planning on it, and then I was like, you know, that's why we keep dying, because I keep trying to get the captain. The capitan. But, there's an intel. Nope, that's the bitch. Actually, no, I think I got you. I tranked you. Fucking die. Oh my god, I don't even know what's going on. Okay. Doctor! I know, you're not supposed to kill them, but, who cares? We're playing Killzone. Alright, here we go. This is the first part of the mission. There is two parts of this mission, so we'll probably, once we finish this part, I'll probably end the video, actually, because it'll be a good ending part once we steal these encryption codes, because that is one half of the mission done. Then we have to blow up the server room. I got a hack, so give me a minute. Oh, mad hacker. Oh my god. Look at me. I am killing it. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. I am so good at hacking. I'm a hacker, guys. We're gonna turn this on. Normally I go ghost, because they just don't know where I am. It's hilarious. But, oh, look at that bitch. You're an athletic one, aren't you? You did that ninja roll. Hey, buddy. Something I don't, understand about the Killzone series. My aim is really bad this video, but, something I don't understand about the Killzone series is you can't go prone. Like, it's not possible to be a player and go prone. It's not in the controls, see? But, the people you fight, like, the bots, not in multiplayer, but the people in campaign, they can go prone. Like, they can be behind that barrier and then roll out onto their stomach and shoot you. Oh, you got a grenade. You're a handy one. You're crafty. Oh my god, are you kidding me? I was making fun of him, and he still killed me. How rude. I'm disappointed. And since we're so close to the end of this video, I'm not gonna cut this. I'm just gonna... Raw footage, baby! Alright, let's go. Oh shit, I forgot there's more people. But yeah, this wasn't the best plan, because my secondary weapon is a rocket launcher. And not just any rocket launcher, like, it needs to be locked on to get the kill, so... It's not the smartest choice. I'm doing it, Ivanov. Gosh, I gotta be Hacker Austin again. Hold on, guys. This is probably my least least favorite part of this game. Other than the shoddy controls. Yeah, I said shoddy controls, even though it's supposed to be called shoddy camera work. I just think it's annoying. Like, having to use the touchscreen. I'm fine with the hacking, but I feel like the hacking was unnecessary. Like, you don't need to have hacking. The thing I really don't like is that there's no normal melee. You always have to touch the screen. And you not just, like... It's not like tap the screen to melee like on Declassified. I thought they did that actually pretty good. But you need to swipe on the screen. And like, I'm fine with that because it adds a little bit more, like, you know, makes melees a little more competitive. A little difficult because they're kind of easy kills. I can just walk up, panic knife, and kill him. And you can't really do that in the multiplayer. But with that control scheme, the problem is when you melee somebody in multiplayer... It could be something different. It could be to the side, like to the right, to the left, up. It could be, actually no, it's not up. It could be down. It could be diagonal to the right, diagonal to the left, like whole bunch of things. So you gotta wait a second. If you're getting meleeed, you know when the thing's about to pop up. So you're ready. And it's the same thing every time. It's swipe up. So before the thing even pops up, they're already spamming swipe up. And it's really annoying, because it's almost impossible to get a melee kill because of that. The only time you can really get a melee kill is when you're playing against a noob, or when their touchscreen doesn't work, or if they just plain don't know what they're doing. Steal the encryption codes. Alright. Where is he? He's up there somewhere. Hold on, we're gonna let him open the door once we get to the engine room. Unless we have to fight more enemies, but I don't think we do. Hey, dude. Man, look at this. These are all the illegal ISA guns they stole. And they're taken to Helgen. Get to the engine room. That's what we're doing. Come on, Ivanov. Enough with the fucking chit-chat. Open the door. Open sesame. Open sesame. Open sesame. Oh, shit. I'm a magician. Holy... Ivanov, you fat ass. Get out of my way. Open sesame. Oh, I was a little late. But it works. The engine room. What will happen in the next video? Only 90% of my viewers know because they've all played Killzone. But I'm gonna pretend like this is a good cliffhanger.